All right, guys, welcome. This is Wayne Hoffman. I'm totally blown away. Now, am I right? Really quickly,
I gotta go back.
Okay, bye. Really quickly.
All right, Wayne.
You read signals? Are you reading her eyes? Her mouth?
That's a small
portion. Drinking the coke.
Of it.
Okay.
Yeah. So basically, in a nutshell, there's not just one way to do it. I use a lot of tools. It's like when a guy builds a house.
Right.
He uses millions of tools to build a house. So I have a toolbox, and depending on the person, I'll use a different tool.
Wow. Travis, how much time do we have here, just so we know what we're looking at?
I think we can do. We're gonna think of what we want.
Yeah, we're gonna think of what we want for dinner, and I want you to figure out what I'm thinking about for dinner tonight.
Now, here's the thing. This was again for the viewers. I am just learning about this right now.
Yeah, just met us.
This is just like a. Yeah. So who's gonna think?
Me.
Okay. Now I know this is weird. We're gonna do it in a different way.
Okay.
I want you to clear your mind. Imagine you go on a free vacation.
Okay.
Where would you go? Tell us.
Tell you?
Yeah.
Okay, Maui.
All right. Imagine you're in Maui.
Okay.
Now,
that's good.
When you're in Maui, I want you to tell us all what you would eat in Maui, particularly, but say it out loud.
Seafood.
Okay. Any particular kind?
No, really anything. Fish, shrimp. Do you want me to pick one?
Yeah, pick one.
Okay, fish.
Okay, now you could have said anything literally in the world, anything that you could eat as a human being.
Mm-hmm.
And is that something you just thought of right now on the spot?
Yes.
I know. And I had a feeling this was going to happen. I wrote something on a post-it note.
Shut your mouth.
Unfold it.
Shut your mouth.
There are two things written on
it.
Read it out loud. Out loud.
Maui and fish. Shut your mouth. What just happened? Ew.
It is official.
I weirded out. How did you do that? No, but
how is this in your pocket? How did you know that's what I was going to say?
Because I'm a mentalist.
Okay, let me ask you something. Do you have like a million post-its?
No, just one. I promise. Yeah.
I can't.
Wait, let's try something else. Let's do another thing.
Okay. I'll think of my favorite.
Here, how about this? Clear your mind.
Okay,
don't think of anything.
Okay, got it.
I don't know what's about to happen. Where did you grow up?
Washington, D.C.
Washington, D.C. or was it Virginia?
No, D.C. Taxation without representation.
Got it.
Yeah.
I'm going to write something. You ready?
Okay.
You will say, imagine you go to a convenience store and you get some change back.
Okay.
You could take, obviously you could get any amount of change back. Ready?
30 seconds.
Here we go. I'm going to go with this. Ready? I have something written here. Tell us all. How much change did you get back from the convenience
store? Just change?
Yes.
57.
Okay, now you could have said anything under the sun, right?
Yeah.
Check it out. Read what it says.
What the heck?
57 cents.
Erica, I'm uncomfortable.
Hi, DBL Nation. We are back here with Wayne, and Travis is here, but Wayne had him do something during that break, so let's see if we can figure out what's going on.
Yeah. So I basically told him, start thinking of somebody and all the people you know. Think of a person. So are you thinking of a person right now?
Yeah.
Cool. Now the hard part. I have to try to figure out what you're thinking. Now, did you tell anyone what you're thinking or no?
No.
Okay, awesome.
And no one knows this person.
Great. So nobody here knows this person?
Yeah.
So it's just a random person that's in your mind right now. And obviously, I wouldn't know.
Yeah,
it would
no
be
way.
Impossible. But I don't know anything about you.
Yeah,
I forget your name already.
Yeah, absolutely.
What is it?
Travis.
Travis.
Yeah.
Officially.
Yeah.
Wait, okay. So now, the weird stuff. Think of the name. Just think of it.
Okay.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G. Now, the viewers are going to see what I'm getting as I'm getting it, all right? Ready? A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, O, W, X, Y, Z. There was another person in your mind for like a split second, and you almost went with them, and then you switched it to a different person. Mm-hmm. I don't know if you thought in your mind it was too obvious or something.
Yeah.
Yeah, but now I'm getting that you ended on a male figure. I'm getting a line. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, O, W, X, Y, Z. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K. Is the person younger than you?
No.
Older?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Because I'm getting two different people. Something like this.
Whoa.
Is it a relative?
No.
Okay. Interesting. This is what I'm getting from you. And everybody at home, you guys can see this. For the first time out loud, tell us what name are you thinking of?
Luke.
Whoa! Oh, no!
Get out of here. Yeah, he lives in Nashville.
Oh, right.
I said we're going to Mexico in a few weeks, and that's what came to my mind because we were just texting about a trip we're taking. So
nice.
Was it good?
Enjoy your trip.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, of course. Pounders right here. That was good. Good. Yeah, I always thought I wanted my name to be Luke.
What we got? Are we wrapping?
Can we do another break with you? Will you stick around?
Yeah, I'm just hanging out.
Let's do another break. Next break. Cool.
Weird. Okay. You don't have to take that out of mind. Something wrong.
Okay.
Cool. Are we live right now?
Yeah.
Hey, everybody! I don't know. This is my first time here, so I'm going to try to read her mind. Just don't concentrate on anything. Just go kind of blank.
Okay.
You know what I mean? Zone out for a second. Just look at me. I'm going to get whatever I get out of her head. It's going to be this. I'm getting a lot more from you than I wanted. This is a great. Don't worry, I won't tell a soul. I bet they'd love to know all of that, though. Something like, I'm getting three things from you, okay? I don't know what they mean or what the significance is. I'm getting three different words. Something like, actually, it's like four words. I don't know what this is. I don't think this is something like this. I don't think that's part of it. This is something like this.
Oh my God.
Okay, I'm gonna show you. Is there something in your mind that starts
seconds.
With the letter S?
Yes.
Are there three words involved in it?
Yes.
Is it something close to this?
Oh!
Yeah?
Yes.
What is it? Tell me.
Oh my God.
She has something in her things. What is this?
She Shed Studio.
I did get it. I crossed out Shed because I was like, that doesn't make sense. I thought it was like Sed. She
it's
said.
My studio. She said She Shed Studio.
Wow. Okay. I didn't know you had a studio. That's cool. I don't get that much.
Oh my gosh.
Weirdness happens today. So your name again?
John.
John Wayne Hoffman, officially.
Nice to meet you.
My pleasure. I'm going to try to now get into his mind and figure out something he's thinking. Now, apparently you are a DJ, and you have a DJ name.
I do.
All right, think of whatever that name is now. Start with just the letters in the spelling, or if it's a number, I don't know, think of the number. Think of like, you know, picture it in your mind now. Do you use the words, like the phrase DJ something or not?
No.
You don't? Wow, okay, actually this is surprising. Most people are like, DJ cool guy or something like, good for you, thank you for being different. No offense to anyone that uses the DJ title. Think of it. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J. First of all, I'm seeing color. Does it have anything to do with color or like a rainbow or like shooting lasers or maybe that's just a memory in your mind?
It does.
It does,
it
okay.
Does actually.
It's like I'm seeing color. I don't know what that means, like the primary colors. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, X, Y, Z. A, B, C, I want to say, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P. Would you rather solve a riddle or paint a picture?
Let's paint a picture.
Interesting. All right. Something like this. Like I'm getting like something like this. Something like this. I feel like it might even be like a blend of something like this. I'll tell you, actually you guys can see it. Everybody can see it. Tell us out loud, what is your DJ name?
Prismatic.
Prismatic.
Yes.
Oh my God.
I got Prismatic.
It's a tough one, I know.
That was
tough,
good.
But like, that's really good.
Yeah, because I didn't get, like, I never heard of prismatic before, so
yeah.
I wouldn't, like, come up with
well,
that.
Well, I'll tell you this. What I was kind of thinking in my head, it was difficult. I was thinking of, like, the Pink Floyd Dark Side
you
of the
Moon. You know what? Oh, I am so angry I didn't say that.
I was thinking of that.
The triangle
yeah,
thing?
Yeah, with
that's
the,
what
with
I
colors.
Was picturing.
Yeah, yeah. I was thinking of that.
I should have said that. I don't know if you're going to believe me, viewers, but I was picturing the
yeah,
pyramid
yeah, yeah.
with the color shooting out. Damn,
yeah.
I should have said
no,
that.
No, you were good. You
Damn
were really
it.
Close.
That's crazy. But yeah, so Prism, check out Prismatic.
Yes.
There you go. Check him out.
Prism Automatic. Thank you so
yeah,
much. That's
you.
Awesome. Thank you
yeah,
for being in
awesome.
The studio today.
Of course, man. This is... What's up? What's up? We're back. This is Wayne Hoffman checking in with Jure.
Jure for the sleigh. Hello.
All right.
Yeah.
We're in. So I'm going to try to read Jure's mind now. Be honest, are you a skeptic or are you a believer, if you had to choose?
I'm in the middle,
you know,
I would
cool.
say, yeah.
I like it.
Yeah.
Any magical things are possible, but you also gotta analyze.
Exactly.
Cool. That's called a channel B, so knowing that tells me a lot. Now, right now, you have something in your mind, right?
Mm-hmm.
You didn't write it down, you didn't tell anybody, literally
no.
nobody here knows. You didn't, there's no, it's just in your head.
Right.
Think of it. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M. Is it random or meaningful?
It's random.
Totally random?
Yeah.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, X, Y, Z. I'm getting letters from you. Is it more than one word or did you just go for one?
One word.
Because I'm getting, you like thought of a word and then changed it.
Kind yep.
of. I know. Getting the letters. I'm getting a C, I'm getting a, it starts with an R?
No.
No? An O?
Yes.
Okay, because it's, no, it's not an R, it's an N, it's upside down. Whoa, this is crazy. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, X, Y, Z. A, B, C, D, E, F, something like this. This is really random. I'm showing everybody, okay? It's a totally random thing. Mm-hmm. You didn't tell anybody.
No.
You didn't write it down.
No.
It's just in your head.
Yeah.
What are you thinking?
Occasions.
What? Wow. Get the
What?
What?
Okay. Okay. Yeah.
What?
You have to call somebody. So.
Yeah. That's crazy.
If you want to have your mind read, you just need to find a mentalist. It's just what you got to do, because this doesn't happen every day. So we're going to try something. I'm over here messing around on my phone. What's up, people? All right. You ready?
Yeah.
And your name?
My name's Rob.
Welcome.
Yeah,
also known as Iron Man. Check this out, man. I got one of those in my closet, too, bro. You know? Look at me. Now, oh, by the way, just earlier, he said, hey, can you tell me what got me into working in television? That's where we're at right now, basically. So you didn't tell me, you didn't tell anybody. I don't know if anybody else here knows, but think of it. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, X, Y, Z. A, B, C, D, E, F, G. It hedges in the way, now I'm looking at you and I can guesstimate approximately age, I can look at your stature, you know, you're a strong dude. Hold out your hand. Okay, physical, right? Watch this. A, B, C, D, E. I'm gonna say this. Something like this. This is what I think he's gonna say, or this is what is on his mind. What got you into television? I think I have it here. We'll see. What is it? Tell me.
I was a house painter before this.
A house painter?
Uh-huh.
Or we could also say I painted homes. Does that count?
Is that real? Is that real?
Okay.
Rob?
Okay, I feel like I'm talking to like a star. Okay, really quickly, a lot of people writing in, they're like, can you do the Coke thing with vodka? Someone wrote that. Can you fill it up with vodka? Are you married and does your partner, do you have trouble dating because you read people's minds?
Yeah, so I usually do it with kegs, you know, raise the keg. But yeah, I could do vodka. But I do, yes, you can do it with pretty much anything. Yeah, I just picked that because why not? Yeah, because I could. And you had them in the green room and you had bottles of water. It was one of the two. Anyway, married, I'm engaged.
Mazel tov.
Dating is always a treat because I know what people are thinking and I can tell if people are lying. So I have to run everything through a filter. I have to go, okay, what would a normal person do in this situation? So if I know something, I don't necessarily say it. I react in a way that's natural. So I have to put everything I do through a filter.
Interesting. It's exhausting.
It's life.
Okay.
You know what
so
I mean?
You're used to it with a routine.
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah.
Okay, so a lot of people writing in, there is something called a cold read, which is incredibly hard to do, but in which you even said it, oh, Sam's wearing something natural. You sort of look at things, and at one point I saw you doing this with a pen or something. You're doing a lot of things all at
yes.
once. Am I right?
The hardest part is making it look like I'm doing
nothing.
Now, what I did here was not cold reading.
Right.
Because that's general statements like you
you're
like
the liver.
You know, you like sunshine.
Yeah.
You know, getting a specific flower and a daisy and getting a specific word, that's getting specific. You
and
don't do that in cold.
Is that using only, are you using sort of signals or are you also going deeper?
So,
does that make sense to you?
This is the best analogy I could give you to explain it briefly. If you ask a contractor, a person who builds homes, if you say, hey, what tool do you use to build a home? You can't answer that.
Right.
They have a toolbox that they go to depending on the specific moment. Mm. And I do the same thing. So I have hundreds of tools that I use and access depending on the situation, the person, the moment, and I'm doing a million different things all at the same time.
It's like the Da Vinci of thought, you know what I mean? Well, real pleasure if you can stick around for a little bit. We would love to have you. If you can't, I understand, to go to your cave or your something castle.
Yeah.
I'm like, yeah, the bat cave. It's unbelievable. But I do want to say, if you watched earlier, Kelly has said, what am I eating for dinner? And he said, what's in my pocket? Where do you want to go? Where do you want to go on vacation? She said, Maui. What would you eat? Fish. And he goes, what's this in my pocket? And folded up in a post-it note was the words Maui and fish.
Yeah. Had to be there.
But why? That's really weird.
Why not?
But I don't see that close to my mind. Anyway, if you have questions, please let me know, because I'm like really into this. All right. Thanks, guys.